everyone, welcome back to Rimmel's YouTube channel. My name is Mariah Leonard and I am going to be doing this really nice and slightly unique dimensional eye look for the New Year holiday. Now, this New Year is going to be a little bit different than New Year holidays we've experienced in the past, and that's totally okay. I'm going to be taking the opportunity to push myself a little bit out of my comfort zone, which is what I did today by mixing all these different tones, trying out a look that I want to wear on New Year, but usually wouldn't. Like, usually I would gravitate towards something very glittery, very cool toned, very safe for me. And I wanted to try something to get myself inspired for when we're finally able to go out and really celebrate New Year. Anyway, I hope that you guys enjoy this video and find it helpful. If you do, feel free to give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to Rimmel for more videos just like this one. And yeah, let's begin. All right, so to begin, I'm gonna be using the Magnifies Jewel Rocks Edition Eyeshadow Palette, and I really love the tones in this palette. The shades are rich, intense, and long-lasting, crease-proof, smear-proof, and wear all day. And the first one I'm gonna be going in with is this mustard yellow, and I'm gonna take this almost all the way up to the brow bone because this particular shade of yellow really helps to frame out each individual color we're gonna be using. You'll see it at the end, it really makes everything pop. And then right in the crease to add some depth, I'm gonna be going in with the peach shade. I'm just focusing this right in that area, very slightly blending that up into the yellow. Again, this is all about kind of groundwork and framing things out. And then as you can see, this green is really popping and those two shades are really bringing out the depth of this green. It's a nice matte shade and it really blended itself out. As you can see, the more I'm patting it, the more it's just diffusing itself, which I really love in an eyeshadow. It's very easy to work with, very user friendly. And then to diffuse it even further and kind of melt it into those other two shades we use, I am gonna blend it out just a little bit more at the edges and then kind of fade it back in toward the inner corner. And then to add some unique texture and dimension, I'm gonna go in with this metallic blue, and I really love the reflect of this. I thought it played really well with the other shades we used so far while still standing on its own and bringing a lot of unique tone to the look. And then to kind of play that up, that blue tone, I went in with this kind of seafoam green with a little bit of a yellow shift, and this is what really made everything look really tonally unique. As you can see, when I'm going back in with our original two shades, they just make these other tones really pop, especially that mustard. It's kind of grounding everything and giving it that base it needs to frame out those more colorful shades. And then on the lower lash, I'm just gonna mirror everything we did on the lid, but exclude the more metallic shades because I really want those to be the focal point of the look, where when the light hits the eye, that's what you see is the reflect of the metallic shades. I felt like taking them to the bottom would just make everything too bold and kind of erase all of the framework that we did for those tones. For mascara, I'm gonna go in with one coat of the Scandalize Volume on Demand Mascara. So this formula is really conditioning and keeps your lashes soft and flexible. Even when you reapply it, it's really nice and buildable. The brush is nice and big too, so it allows you to get in there and comb every lash. Like I said, I applied one coat to my lashes and I found it not only to be really volumizing, but also really lengthening just in one coat. To round off the rest of the look, I'm gonna begin with bronzer, and I'm using the Natural Bronzer in the shade Sun Bronze, and this gives you a really nice sun-kissed glow. So this tone in particular on my skin really complemented the mustard shade that I used on the eyes. And what I like about it especially is that it gave such an airbrushed finish to my skin. It didn't pick up on any texture, it didn't look muddy, it didn't kind of stick to any dry patches whatsoever. It was just a wash of truly natural looking sun-kissed bronze. And to complement that, I went in with the Maxi Blush in the shade Third Base. This is a really nice neutral peach tone that I purposefully chose to bring out the peach tone on the eyes. And you'll see as I begin to apply it, the eyes do start to look a little bit more peachy in the crease. This blush is really lightweight and buildable. It's a really nice micro fine powder that glides on smoothly. It's very similar to the bronzer in that regard. It didn't pick up again on any dry patches, didn't make my cheeks look dry at all, even when I really built the product up, and it just gave such a natural flush to my face in a way that really tied the look together so smoothly and seamlessly. And then to finish off the whole look, I used the Stay Matte Liquid Lip Color in the shade Mocha. This is a really nice, almost mustardy tan color that I really feel tied in the tones of everything else and really finished everything off and brought everything together. This formula is kiss proof, touch proof, and waterproof, and has a nice velvety matte finish. It's not overly drying whatsoever and quite honestly felt like I had nothing on my lips. It was super, super light and airy.
All right, everyone, that wraps up today's mixed toned dimensional eye look for New Year. I hope that you really enjoyed this, like I said, and found it helpful. Feel free to follow me on social as well. I'm here on YouTube as well as over on Instagram. All of my handles will be linked in the down bar below. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching and for tuning into this video. I hope that you have a lovely and safe holiday. Bye.